Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Recently we did the original Chex Party Mix and we did two versions. We did the 1952 version and also the updated 2009 version, just to let you see how the original Chex Party Mix had changed over the years. Well, in recent years there have been many recipes for Chex Party Mix and a lot of flavors have been introduced. And one of those is a chocolate peanut butter combination that is called Chex Muddy Buddies. That's Muddy Buddies. A lot of people call it Puppy Chow or Puppy Food. It's a sweetened version of Party Chex Mix. And it doesn't have the peanuts or any kind of nuts unless you want to add them. It doesn't have pretzels or bagel bites or anything like that. It's very to the point, but it does have chocolate and peanut butter. So let's get started with putting our Chex mix together. I've decided to use, because there is some variability in the recipe, wheat Chex, and this isn't the same brand, rice, we'll say Chex, this says rice bits, and then corn Chex, or corn bits. And I've measured out already 3 cups of each one. Now in the recipe, they're going to tell you to use 9 cups. And you can use any one of these, or you can use any combination of these. And also they make a chocolate Chex mix. So if you want to put that into the blend, or if you want it all to be chocolate Chex mix with this added on, it's your recipe. So let's start by just emptying the 3 cups of wheat Chex and the 3 cups of rice Chex and the 3 cups, which I did measure with measuring cups, of corn Chex. And then I'm going to blend those together.
I will tell you, I decided to do a stovetop version, although the recipe from the Chex company actually is a microwavable recipe. And this is not the type of thing that you have to wait an hour for it to bake in the oven. We're just gonna make the topping, pour it over there, and then put it on wax paper, and we're done. So these recent versions that Chex has come out with, and individuals also have come out with their own versions, are very quick and easy to do. And they're just great for munching on while you're watching a football game, or you're watching a movie, or just watching TV, or relaxing on the sofa. We'll start with butter. And what I have here is some salted butter. I need 1/2 stick, which is 1/4 cup. And I've already melted it on the stove over here. To this, I'm going to add some semisweet, you can see my label here, semisweet chocolate chips. And I've measured them out to be 1 cup. Those will be melted, those will be melted. So I'm putting them in my skillet. And then I need some peanut butter. You can use creamy, you can use chunky, whichever one you like. But you need 1/2 cup. And in a lot of cases, I know that you have seen a recipe and have access to it, but my purpose is just to remind you of it sometimes, because a lot of times you may be very familiar with something and then it just takes that little nudge of, oh yeah, I used to make that, which I'm trying to do here. So we're going to go over to the stove, turn it on, and I need to get this melted. So you're going to have to give me a couple of minutes for this to melt, and then we'll come back and it won't be long till we'll have our Muddy Buddies. It only takes a minute or so to get all of this melted, and you can see the consistency. Now you could do this in the microwave, but don't put a pan in. Use a microwavable bowl in order to do it, and just it might be a minute or so, but watch what it's doing and stir it occasionally if you use that. I need 1 teaspoon of vanilla to add at this point. And I'll stir that in. And we have our nice chocolatey, peanut buttery blend that we're going to pour over that cereal. So I'm gonna go over here and just try to drizzle this chocolate over the cereal. And you don't want to be too slow on this because the chocolate might have a tendency to set up and you want to get it to coat as much as you can. So just rake that out and get it going, but try to get it all. And I think I have as much as I can get. It's kind of drippy here. And then it's going to be messy looking. Don't worry about that. Just try to get these coated. And I think this looks good enough. So what we're going to do is bring this over to my workspace over here where I have prepared a gallon-sized plastic bag, and I also have some confectioner's sugar. Now, in the recipe, there is a 2-gallon size bag called for, and I don't have those. So I'm just going to do half the recipe at one time. We have 1 1/2 cups of confectioner's sugar. So I'm just going to put like 3/4 of a cup, half of it, in there. And then just kind of estimate half of this. So we're just going to do it in segments so that I can reuse my bag since I don't have a huge 2-gallon bag. Then when you get that, you don't need to zip like this. Just hold it at the top, hold it closed, and then shake. And what's going to happen is the confectioner's sugar is going to coat the chocolate, which is coating the cereal. So when you feel like you've got all of that coated very well, which it'll look something like that, then go ahead and let it come out on some wax paper that you've got ready over a tray. So there'll be some loose pieces of confectioner's sugar, but we'll just pick this up out of the confectioner's sugar when we store it. Doesn't that look good? Now I'm just going to repeat the process. Let me spread this out to just give you the look of the entire thing. We're going to repeat that process for the other half, but if you have the 2-gallon bag, you can do it all in one step and you would be done. And they're cooled down quite a bit, so I wouldn't store them quite yet, but I would start eating on them right now. When you do get ready to store them, just put them in a Ziploc bag or a couple, or you might use a Tupperware container, any kind of plastic container that has a lid, or it could be a glass container with a screw on top, something like that. So I'm going to go away and finish the rest of these, and then I'll show you the finished result in a few minutes. I finished up my second batch and poured it over the top and spread it out, and now these are cool. If we were ready to eat them right now, then I would put them in little serving bowls and we would be munching on them as we do some kind of sedentary activity. But we're not ready for these right now, so I'm going to store them away. And really a nice thing is a container that has a lid. So I'll just start by using a large utensil here. How did you try these Chex Muddy Buddies, or more popularly known as Puppy Chow?